With just 20 days until Election Day, both candidates are ramping up outreach efforts. Former President Trump attempting to appeal to women voters during a Fox News town hall. The overturning of Roe versus Wade remains a top concern for some.
Why is the government involved in women's basic rights?
This issue has torn this country apart for 52 years, so we got it back in the states.
Mr. Trump doubling down on his divisive rhetoric, painting Democrats as the enemy within.
They're very dangerous. They're Marxists and communists and fascists.
Vice President Harris taking a different approach, seeking to reach across the aisle to Republican voters in Pennsylvania while criticizing her opponent.
Donald Trump is increasingly unstable, and as has been said by the people who have worked closely with him even when he was president, he's unfit to be president of the United States.
Both candidates working to mobilize voters.
We're going to do the work. That's about knocking on doors and calling people and emailing.
As soon as you can, go to the polls and vote.
Many Americans are casting their ballot before November 5th.
Why did you vote early this year?
Honestly, because Donald Trump told me to.
What made it an easy decision?
Sanity versus insanity, criminal versus prosecutor.
More than 300,000 showed up for the first day of early in-person voting in Georgia, doubling 2020 numbers. Record-breaking turnout in a razor-thin race.
Next week, in-person absentee voting gets underway in Wisconsin, another critical battleground state. It's also a state with competitive down-ballot races that could energize voters and make a difference in this tight presidential race. In Washington, Bree Jackson, NBC News.